From inside Rogers Center in downtown Toronto, the show brings you a matchup of division rivals. It's the New York Yankees and the Toronto Blue Jays.
And now,
first pitch coming your way next.
2023 Toronto Blue Jays.
Just about to get underway. And towing the slab, Mark Pryor. What do we need to know here?
Well, you know, this guy wants to be better than that. I mean, the ERA is bloated. He understands that he's got to put his team in a better position to win ball games. And at this point, you have to forget about your own individual stats, and you have to go out there and attack and try to get that W. And if you do that, you'll look up, and most likely that ERA will have dropped over time.
Patient, get your pitch, huh?
Absolutely crushed, and that one is gonna land by a man down by the river. He rockets one to right, and that gives him a lead. It's 1-0.
That one was a hanger, and pitchers typically don't get away with making a mistake like that. And right there, he made him pay.
Runner at first with two away. Ken Griffey Jr., the next to hit.
The center fielder.
Griffey was an instant sensation when he burst onto the major league scene back in 1989. A sweet-swinging 19-year-old kid, and he got to play alongside his dad. He was a special player.
Looking good,
looking good. Let's go. And he deals. Oh, now this one is blasted to right. Forget it. Way back there and gone. A two-run homer, and they grab the lead. It's 2-1. Well, that swing changes things.
Yes, it does. They were in striking distance, and they found a way to fight back big time. He got on plane with that high fastball, then look how his bat stays in the zone for a long time. Absolutely crushed that pitch.
Evan Longoria digs in now. Longoria hitting better against right-handers this year, so some reverse splits there.
Nobody here, nobody.
And a pitch. In the air, fairly deep to right field. Squeezes it, and there's one down.
Batting seven, the second baseman, Andre.
Here's some real power at the plate. Babe Ruth.
Kind of a throwback. No batting gloves.
Singing, you can't ask for anything more. This guy checks all the boxes offensively.
He is the ultimate professional, and it doesn't just start at game time. It starts in the afternoon, the way he prepares and gets ready for the ball game. I tell you what, his teammates feed off of the leadership that he shows on and off the field.
Swings and blasts one deep to left center. You can kiss it goodbye. He got just enough of that one. His second home run of the game. It's 4-2. Singy, the ball is jumping off his bat.
Yes, it is. Tons of loud contact. Man, it's been impressive. Power versus power right there, like two locomotives colliding. Who's going to win? Well, a really good job there by the hitter getting the top hand working. Powers that fastball out of here.
And next for Toronto, Jim Thome grounded out his first time.
First baseman, number 25, Jim Thome.
2-2 now. And there's a fly ball deep right field back there. Makes the catch up against the wall. 1-2-3 go the Blue Jays. They trail it here 4-2. First and second, one out. Now it's the right fielder, Babe Ruth. And a foul ball.
Come on, baby. Get your pitch up. Stay through. Let's go.
On the ground, right side. Over to Larkin. Double play. What a twin killing to end the inning.
Well, the second baseman made that one look easy. Great feed to the shortstop. Shortstop completes the play. They get out of a jam, and they end the inning.
Here's the catcher, Shea Langeliers. Flied out his first time. Longoria stands at first with one out. And that one is lifted in the air. Ruth pulls it down, out number two.
Up next to the Blue Jays, the pitcher, Moore.
And up next for New York, Babe Ruth. And the way he's going in this one, we've been waiting for his spot to come around again.
All right, listen, everyone, stop what you're doing right now. This guy's got two home runs already. Now he's going for number three.
Fought off foul.
Hey, let it rip, let it rip.
Absolutely crushed. And that one is going to land by a van down by the river. He flexes his power with that swing, and they add to their lead. It's 11-2.
Well, he comes through big time with the grand slam here, but you also got to give some credit to the guys ahead of him. Good at bats to get on base and really set the table for a very special moment in this one.
And now Evan Longoria. And when you talk about elite defensive three, third baseman, this guy is at the top of the list.
Longoria.
Come on, fellas, let's go.
The 1-2. In the air, right field. Ruth under this one. Pulls it down and he makes the catch. And there's two down.
Now batting, second baseman, Andrés Giménez.
Here's a big power threat, Babe Ruth. And a chance to make some history here, Chris.
Yeah, he's homered three times so far, and now he gets another chance, at least we think. We'll see if the pitcher gives him anything to hit. It's so rare to see a three-homer performance, but even more special for that player to get another chance at the plate to do it again for four.
Hey, lucky kid up there, kid, huh?
Schmidt back to work. And that one hammered back there. You can kiss it goodbye. Home run number 55 on the year. And they add on. It's 13-2.
Wow, this is awesome. I mean, a four-homer game, they're just so rare, they're so special, and just so tough to pull off as well. Everything has to line up for you, but of course, you got to make it happen too. And these are the types of performances that people just don't forget, and it's definitely going to live on in history.
Back here at Rogers Center, ready for the bottom of the eighth. Here's the Toronto catcher, Shea Langeliers.
The catcher, Shea Langeliers.
That one is hammered right field, way back there. On the warning track, and hauls it in.
Now batting, the pitcher, Clark.
So up next, Babe Ruth trying to do what no player has ever done at this level. He's looking for his fifth homer of the game.
I never thought I'd see this moment. I mean, this is unbelievable. This guy gets a chance to hit his fifth home run. Whether he does it or not, this next at bat's a pretty special one.
Oh, now, here we go.
Absolutely crushed, and that one is going to land by a man down by the river.
His 56th home run of the season, and they throw a pair on the board. It's 18-2.
Unreal. Absolutely unreal, Boog. I mean, this is an all-time performance right here. Five home runs in a single game. Are you kidding me? This is something we're never going to forget. A performance that clearly will go down in history as one of the best ever. And I'm just in awe of what we've seen. And he's getting a standing O for me right now. Well, I don't know what they did in the cage today or on the field for batting practice, but when you win by double digits, something is clicking. That batting coach feels pretty good about himself right now, but more so the players. They can't wait for the next one. Come back out, score, and get another W.
So this one got a little out of hand. For Chris Singleton and our entire outstanding crew here at MLB The Show, I'm John Ciampi. Thanks for joining us.
Time of the ball game, 4 hours and 3 minutes. Thank you for joining us here tonight. And we remind you to please drive home safely.
And welcome in, everybody. Glad you're with us. The show has an AL East matchup. It's the New York Yankees and the Toronto Blue Jays. John Ciampi on the play-by-play with you. Chris Singleton providing the color. And Chris, we've got an opportunity to watch one of the true superstars of the sport. Wiz Kid, always exciting to see him in action. And it seems like he consistently finds a way to impact the game.
Yeah, Boog, it's offensively at the plate, defensively when he's on the bases. And this guy's just a heads-up player, but he's got so much talent, and he makes the most of that. I believe it starts with his preparation because you never see him give away an at-bat.
All right, we'll be back to get this one started after this. Just about ready to roll here. And starting in this one, Babe Ruth. Chris, he is a fun one to watch do his thing out there.
Well, he comes in carrying a career ERA under 3. He's been fantastic ever since he broke into the big leagues. Can't wait to watch him pitch today.
And next for New York, Babe Ruth.
He's been such a good hitter with runners in scoring position. Some guys just take it to another level. For him right now at the plate, it's like everyone else is in slow motion and he's in full speed.
And a foul ball. Left-hand hitter waits. Out towards right center. That's well struck. That's back. Pulls it in on the warning track.
Every day during batting practice, these outfielders get about 10 minutes of balls in the gaps. They practice this, and when the game comes.
Back now in Toronto. And the batter now, Babe Ruth.
Well, after putting up a nice inning on offense, got some runs across, this is where you look for the starter to go out there, have a shutdown inning. Don't give that other team any hope. You just hope that he can get through this inning, get the bats back up there while they're hot.
Absolutely crushed. And that one is going to land by a van down by the river.
He'll touch them all. His 57th homer of the season. It's 2-1. He only needed one swing to square it up.
Not wasting any time in that at bat, Boog. Aggressive, and it paid off. With a low 90s fastball, you have to live on the edges and hit your spots. If you don't, you'll get hit hard. Really good swing there. Patient, waited for it. It was like BP all over again.
We head to the bottom of the fifth. And here's the catcher, Shea Langeliers.
For the Jays, the catcher, Shea Langeliers.
And the 0-1. Fly ball to right. Ruth in position. And a quick out number one.
The pitcher, Bay.
And now for the Jays, Barry Larkin.
Hey, we got one here.
And the right-hander deals. A rope into right, and that's a base hit. Quick throw back in. Lead runner holds it second with one gone.
Multi-hit game for him now, and with the lack of results he's been having lately, I'm sure he's feeling some relief. Anytime you rip a line drive the other way, you feel really good about what you did.
Ken Griffey Jr. next up for the Blue Jays. This guy has turned into a beast.
Yeah, we got one.
With Jr., probably one of the sweetest swings we have ever seen, and certainly as signature a swing as any player has ever had. Kicks and deals. That to right. Ruth has a beat on it. Puts the squeeze on that one. Runner tagging from third. That's a sacrifice fly as he comes across, and they're up by 3.
So many times that one gets out of here and into the seats, but he'll take the sac fly RBI. Good job to get that run in from third.
And stepping in for the Yankees, Babe Ruth.
Now that the right fielder, Dave Lewis.
Here you go, baby. Find a good pitch.
To the right side. Oh, great stop. To first.
Out.
Fine play in the hole for the out.
Well, on the mound, very efficient. Able to produce an outcome, it seems like, within the third or fourth pitch of just about every at-bat.
So digging in, Barry Larkin.
With this kind of lead, he can swing freely. Try to hit the ball out of the park. Do what he loves to do.
Larkin.
One down, base is empty. That one ripped way back there. Hauls it in on the warning track.
Now batting left fielder.
So two down now, and here is Jim Thome. He's already homered in this game.
Number 25, Jim Thome.
Oh, now this one's high and deep, way back there, on its way, gone. Another homer. He's done it again. His second homer of the game. It's 6-2. That's their third home run of the game.
They're having a lot of fun at the plate in this one. They've got the long ball working for them on autopilot. When a guy's got a real hard fastball, you can't overswing. All you've got to do is get the bat head to the spot. If you do, he supplies the power, and you'll get to jog around the bases like he did right there.
So one out, nobody on. And up next for New York, Babe Ruth. The Yankees looking to rally. And first offering is fouled off.
Hey, see, hey,
at the belt
it,
fires. That one is absolutely belted.
Come on, get out of here.
You can kiss it goodbye. He made him pay for that one. His 58th home run of the season. It's 6-3.
Oh, that one got in the jet stream on a line drive. We saw the numbers on the backs of the jerseys of the outfielders, which is usually bad news. And all of a sudden, they're back in this ballgame. Well, this was a tightly played game. Got a little of everything. Some timely hitting, runs on the board, key pitching and defense in certain spots. Definitely a fun one to watch.
6-5 the final here today. For Chris Singleton and our entire crew here at MLB The Show, thanks for stopping by. I'm John Ciambi. Talk to you soon.
Seven men on base. For the Yankees, 5 runs on 9 hits, no errors. They left 6 men on base. Time of the ball game, 3 hours and 32 minutes. Thank you for.